I had this shoot with a review of the Kyrie 6. Not a big fan of the Kyries, not a big fan of the player, not a big fan of the shoes, but I love some of the aspects of the Kyrie series used to always deliver. Their traction, for starters, have been amazing, top of the line. They always tried something different, but at the same time, they did not stray too far from their original starting point. Kyrie 2 had the best traction in many people's opinion, and I cannot argue with them on that. It has similar blade nodules along the lateral and the medial side to provide that extra deep bite as you move for a crossover side to side. It doesn't have an outrigger, but the base is wide enough to work as an outrigger itself. The traction is it's a little bit disappointing because it reminds me of the nightmare of the Kyrie 1. The Kyrie 1 had the worst traction ever, possibly the worst traction in Nike history. But we see some semblances or tribute to the Kyrie 1 design here, something that Jordan Brand and other shoes have been doing. But Kyrie's only got his sixth signature, so going back to pay tribute to the old model seems kind of premature. I love the Kyrie 1's mid, low, in-between cut. It molds nicely around your ankle without restricting your movements, and none of the paddings seem to cut in or bite into or chafe into your feet or your ankle or your Achilles. So that was a good part of the Kyrie ones. The heel, they just had some Phylon material, some EVA Phylon type of material. And so the first time you put that on, it's not too bad, but once you start running in them for a few hours, you feel that it's just really clunky and there's not really much response or shock absorption here. Similar situation to the Kyrie 5s. They put the Zoom Turbo. You could feel a little bit of a unique type of Zoom cushioning on the forefoot that's low to the ground, but on the heel you feel something that's just as bad, if not worse, than the Kyrie 1s. For the 6, overall it's a smoother ride. Overall, the midsole injected Phylon that used is a lot less dense. It's a lot softer, so that's good, but nowhere near the ballpark of the Jumpman 2020s, which had some amazingly soft foam that literally eliminated the need for any Zoom bags, and it served its purpose well on the heel. But it also had a bit of a cut-in groove here, a little bit of a donut hole, which provided some extra area for compression or decompression or expansion for the cushioning, so it worked. But as you can see, there's nothing like that, and this is a definite upgrade in terms of cushioning compared to the 5, but still, the heel cushioning, if you're someone who steps hard on your heel or land hard on your heels, you probably want to skip this model. But if you're used to the Kyrie 5s and you felt that was adequate cushioning, then you'll love this more. The 4-foot Zoom, it's lower. I don't know if it's bigger, but it's lower and you can feel it. It's good. It's an improvement from the previous model 5s. The fit is a little weird. This is the EP version, which means it's supposed to provide a wider fit, but for some reason it's got a huge toe box space, but not much of a give in terms of the lateral width. So yeah, keep that in mind when you're trying them on and when you're purchasing them. The fit is a little bit weird. High toe box space and not exactly the widest kind of fit, even if they say EP. Personally, I would like to get the normal fit or just normal fit with a lower toe box. That would suit me fine. I went a whole size up, but this toe box area is it's killing me. Not my go-to shoes when it comes to hitting the courts. Weight-wise, it's a size 10, goes for about size 10 or size 280. It goes for about in terms of the metric system, grams, 430 grams, something like that, which is very light, fairly lightweight. What am I missing? This part, I've praised the Kyrie 1's mid, low, in-between cut, and the way the inner booty, the inners and the foam cradle your feet and it doesn't cut into anything. But for the Kyrie 2, 3, 4, and even 5, they've had this issue of this little part kind of constricting, acting like a boa constrictor, kind of restricting your circulation or eating into your Achilles a little bit. So I wish this was either a little bit lower here, a little bit more deep cut, or use something that's more of a softer type of material that cuts up to here with some really soft elastic material there. That would have provided a much smoother, a comfortable ride. The heel cup, it looks cute. It does serve its purpose without being too heavy weight, too heavy. The strap is useless. I guess if you want to tighten the shoe up and you feel that another strap here provides an additional feeling or sensation of a better lockdown, by all means do indulge, but personally I don't feel the need for this. If anything, they should have a strap here maybe, or bring back the amazing lockdown anti-inversion strap system they've had for the Kyrie 2, which was to have the strap come from here and then lock up right here to prevent rolling your ankle. Yeah, if you can fasten your seat belt this way for your shoes, that is perfect. Why did they not bring it back? The strap itself is pretty thick and heavy. It's a thick TPU or rubber compound. Yeah, I would just cut this whole thing off, because what they only do is the Velcro kind of eats into your laces and other parts of your shoe and mess them up.